phone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks. Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m. Related to the investigation. I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake. Thanks. I'm looking for Lieutenant Carter Blake. Thanks.
Hey. You there! What are you doing?
Lieutenant Blake? I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning. They told me to be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Well, are you coming, Jaden?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. We should know more once the coroner has had a look. Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today.
Do we know the cause of death?
There are no marks on the body. Chances are he was drowned, like the others.
There are a lot of people on the crime scene. Aren't you afraid your men might destroy some clues?
You don't find proof sitting behind a desk. We're not in the habit of trampling things into the ground, even if we're not in the FBI.
No. No, of course not. That's not what I meant.
Tony, I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Do you have any leads?
My men are going over to the scene with a fine-tooth comb. If the killer left anything behind, we'll find it.
I know investigators never like to see FBI profilers turning up, but I'm here to help, if I can.
The only thing I'm interested in is finding the killer. I don't have an ego problem, if that's any reassurance.
Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Well, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden. You come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Strange character, that Blake. Didn't seem too pleased to see me. Harry Cameron, sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Traces of blood detected on the fence behind the railroad line. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. Common traces of footprints leading toward the body. They don't look like those of the police. No correlation with the body for the moment. There's a good chance that they're the killers. Harry Conner. Tire tracks on the side of the boat behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car. Thank you. Sorry, comment. Traces of blood on the railroad track. Comment. Sample of no interest. Comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Harry, comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. Superficial wound on the right thigh. The blood is identical to that on the fence. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. Think I've seen all there is to see. Sample of no interest. Comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
I'm heading back to the office. You staying?
No, I've seen enough. I'm leaving too.
A bat. A rat. A rat's head. crab. Death. Death.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition. I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
It was an accident. Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death. How is Sean?
I know he's disappointed in me. I'm not the father I used to be. He's a great kid, you know. He deserves better.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I no longer want to live. I have no reason to continue.
Not even for your son, Sean.
I couldn't save Jason. Sean doesn't need a father like me.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
I sometimes have these blackouts, times when I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later, but I'm someplace else, and I have no idea how I got there. Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months. We really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain. That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor. Aren't you gonna go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
Do you want to eat something? How did things go at school today?
The teacher yelled at me for being late again. She's gonna send me home the next time it happens.
I'm sorry about that, Sean. Next time, we'll really pull it together, okay? I haven't been on a seesaw in a long time. What do you think?
Yeah. Come on, Dad, make me fly. Come on, Dad. You're not doing it right. You gotta push off at the right time.
What about that merry-go-round? I bet I can push you so fast you won't be able to stay on it.
Great! Dad, as fast as you can. Faster! Whoa! I think my head is spinning.
Good training for astronauts, though. You want to go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay. Pushing Dad. Come on, Dad. Higher. That was cool.
Looks like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay. You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, Sean. Me too.
What are you doing?
I'm coming.
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket. One, please.
That's a dollar.
Do you think it's going to take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
Thank you.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. I'll cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain, Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. We just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get him well together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press are all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
No. Of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Well, I hope you're better at profiling than at tying knots. Oh, forget it. I'll manage. Oh, go see Charlene. She'll show you to your office. Check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We've bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Congratulate Larry on my behalf.
I'll be sure to do that, sir.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work. Step one, change the office. Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on. Eight victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. It's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
Is everything all right, sir?
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marsh. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Sean. We played together for a while, and then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses, and when I turned back, Sean had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Marsh. Every detail can be important.
It must have been about... ...5:30, I think. I'm not really sure.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat. A black coat. And a pair of pants. Green pants.
How could Sean have disappeared without you even noticing? Weren't you right by the carousel?
I went for a short walk around the park, just for a few minutes. When I got back, the carousel had stopped, and Sean wasn't there.
You say you took your son to the park after school, but you didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
I don't know. I panicked. I didn't know what to do.
Did Sean have any particular difficulties, Mr. Mars? Anything that might have caused him to run away?
Sean is a sensitive child. Our relationship has been a little difficult recently.
Everything okay at school? Any particular problems between you and your wife?
My wife and I have been separated for the last 6 months. But Sean would not have gone off without telling his mother and me.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Sean overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Do you think the origami killer...
Listen, your son's probably just run off and he'll turn up in a couple of hours.
But what if it is the origami killer?
Well, then we have about 4 days to find him alive.
Find something?
No, nothing yet, but they're gonna keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the origami killer?
It's still too early to say, but it is a possibility.
What happened, Ethan? How could you lose Sean like that? You should never have taken your eyes off him. I mean, for God's sake, how hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan? Why? Wasn't it enough losing Jason? I'm sorry. That's not what I meant to say.
Good evening to you, sir. Can I help you, sir?
Well, I hope so. My name's Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the origami killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
My son is dead, Mr. Shelby. I have nothing more to say.
The killer has kidnapped another victim. A 10-year-old boy. Like your son, Risa. I have 4 days before we find his body on a deserted stretch of wasteland.
No one did anything to save my son. Now, please, to move along, sir.
You may know something that could help save other people's lives.
I was unable to save the life of my own son. I do not see how I could save the lives of other people.
Oh, do you sell inhalers? I'm all out, and at least I won't go away completely empty-handed.
In the back of this door, to the right.
Thanks.
Good evening, sir. Are you looking for something in particular?
Give me what you got in the register. Don't fucking try anything. Open the register, you dumb fuck. Put the money on the counter. Shit, are you deaf or what? Are you gonna open that fucking register or not?
No, sir. You do not have the right to steal that money from me. I have worked very hard to earn it. You cannot have it.
What did you... Hey, you! Come here! I said come here now! Don't move! Hands up! Put your fucking hands up or I'll shoot!
My name's Scott. What about you? What's your name?
Andrew. My name's Andrew.
Don't panic. Let's just stay calm. Nobody here wants to hurt you. No, we're all just gonna be cool, and everything will be all right.
Yeah. I'm cool, man. Everything's gonna be all fucking right.
You don't really want to shoot anybody, do you? I'm sure we can find a way out of this mess, right? You're not a killer, are you? You just want a few extra dollars. No blood on your head.
No, I'm not a killer. I ain't no killer.
Look, it's not worth it. Put the gun down. Just walk away.
You giving me advice? I'll give you some fucking advice.
I think you're making the biggest mistake of your life. Pull that trigger. I promise you. You'll regret it.
Yeah? I think you're the one who's really gonna regret it. Nice try. For a second there, you almost had me believing all your shit.
Thousand thank you, sir. I don't know what would have happened if you had not been
well,
here.
This I didn't come by for nothing. Have a nice day.
When my boy, Reza, disappeared, I received a letter with a locker ticket inside. Inside the locker, I found this box. I do not understand what it means, but I think it must be a sort of message from the man who took my son from me.
Can I?
Take the box if it can be of any use to you at all. It did not help me to save Reza, but maybe it will help you find the other little boy. Mr. Shelby. I was beginning to think that there was no good to be found in this place. I can see now that I was wrong.
There's someone here. There's someone in the apartment. The phone on the desk. I could call for help. The front door. It's the only way out. If I can reach it, I still have a chance. My cell. On the desk. I need to call for help.
When the parents came home from church, all their children were gone. They searched and called for them, they cried and begged, but it was all to no avail. The children have never been seen again.
the origami figure in my hand after my blackout. It's the same one the killer leaves in the hands of his victims. I've never done origami in my life. It looks like the ticket to a locker. That letter might be linked to Sean's disappearance. I need to show it to the police. Someone sent me that letter for a reason. What does it mean? Some sort of fairy tale? This angel on the ticket, I'm sure I've seen it somewhere before. This doesn't make any sense. It couldn't have been me. I couldn't ever have done that. I have to get out of here and find out what this ticket is about.
Mr. Morris, a few words.
Goddamn reporters. They've been camped outside my house all day.
Mr. Morris, can you confirm that your son has disappeared?
Do you think the origami killer kidnapped him?
Get another car. I'm going to walk straight to that car without stopping on the way.
Are you worried your son might be dead?
Mr. Morris, do you suspect anyone, Mr. Morris?
Do you know if the investigators have any leads?
You lost your son in the park. How do you feel about that?
Please, Mr. Morris!
Mr. Morris, a few words.
Are you going to make an appeal for the killer,
Mr. Morris?
Do you think your son is still alive?
Mr. Morris, can you confirm that your son has disappeared?
Do you think your son is still alive?
Gonna have to make it through the crowd. I can't take crowds. Just can't handle it. I can't make it. Too many people.
Jason!
Jason!
Line 18, box number 3.
Sean.
Where are you? I'm so cold. Dad. Dad.
Close.
The killer is white, age between 30 and 45. He doesn't act on impulse, but plans his crimes in a very meticulous fashion. He doesn't have anything personal against the victims. That's why he covers their faces with mud, to make them anonymous.
Why does he kill them if he doesn't have anything against them?
For him, they're more of an image, a symbol. That's probably why he gives them an origami figure and an orchid as gifts to apologize for what he's done to them.
Very interesting. And where does all that get us?
It builds up a profile of the killer and helps us understand the person we're looking for. It might have been useful if it was done earlier in this investigation.
Continue, Jaden.
One detail attracted my attention. The interval between the time when a victim disappears and the time when the body is found ranges from 3 to 5 days. But the rainfall is always at 6 inches, give or take 10%.
What on earth does that mean?
All the victims are drowned in rainwater. The killer kills only in the fall when there is plenty of rain. It could be that he puts them in some sort of well or tank that is open to the skies and that fills up with rainwater. The more it rains, the less time the victim has to live. Then I studied the geographical distribution of the murders. Generally, a killer commits his first murder near to where he lives, so he has a safe place to flee to if any complications arise. The more confident he becomes, the further he roams from his base. By analyzing the locations where the victims disappeared, I was able to isolate a zone where the killer might live.
And what size is this, zone?
For the moment, about 10 square miles.
Ah, great. There must be 10,000 people live in that sort of area. You gonna question them one by one?
The more clues we get, the more we can reduce the zone. We can then cross-check it with our list of suspects and identify the killer.
So what's next?
There are two suspects whose psychological profile might fit and can be connected to the comfort zone. I'd like to question them.
Ah, damn it. We're wasting our time with this bullshit. The killer's out there somewhere, and we gotta get off our asses and find him.
The killer is no ordinary murderer. He is intelligent, organized, and methodical. You won't find him by patrolling the streets.
Tell me, Agent Jaden, did you get your vast experience on the job, or did you just fucking read about it in some school book?
Your vast experience hasn't prevented 8 victims from being murdered.
Fucking asshole!
That's enough. You said it took 6 inches of rainfall before the victim died. How much time do we have left?
If the weather forecasts are right, less than 72 hours. No answer. We waste our time coming here.
Maybe we should have a little look inside anyway.
There's nobody home.
There is now.
I'm not sure that's entirely legal.
Call the cops.
Looks like Nathaniel Williams is a pretty religious guy.
He's a God-fearing idiot, waiting for the end of the world. We questioned him a few months back because he was causing a disturbance in the park. He was ranting and raving. Said he heard voices. Had this idea in his sick little head that I was the Antichrist. I'd come to Earth to persecute him. Real twisted.
Good timing, Nathaniel. Just the man we're looking for.
Angels and ministers of grace defend us.
I'm Agent Norman Jaden, FBI. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
As God is my witness, I haven't done anything. I'm innocent.
Relax. Nobody's accusing you of anything. We just want to talk. Nathaniel, do you remember where you were last Tuesday at 4:30 p.m.?
Here? I was here. I was praying. All day.
Was there anybody with you?
No. No, I was alone.
You were arrested in a case where a child disappeared from a park. What exactly happened?
I'm innocent. I have nothing to do with those murders. I was in the park because God spoke to me. I was arrested because I am the chosen one. That's all.
Where do you work, Nathaniel? You have a job?
My sole occupation is praying to the all-merciful Lord for the salvation of humanity.
What about the voices, Nathaniel? Do you still hear the voices? We know who talks to you, don't we, Nathaniel? Or we both know who talks to you.
Don't speak that name.
What does he say to you, Nathaniel?
Blake, what are you doing?
I can't talk about it. You mustn't talk about it.
He orders
That's
you to
enough.
Go and find
Leave
new prey,
him alone.
Doesn't he? He needs more and more.
No, you mustn't mention him. You'll bring him here.
He told you to go and find that kid in the park.
Are you out of your mind?
The voices tormented you all night long. You wanted them to stop, didn't you, Nathaniel?
Stop. Stop. That's enough.
So you obeyed them to make them stop. You took that boy with you and you drowned him. Isn't that right?
No. Stop. Stop.
You killed them, didn't you, Nathaniel? Are you going to confess, you bastard?
You are the Antichrist.
Put down the gun,
Nathaniel. I shall
dispatch
you to your father in hell. He is the son of Satan. He was sent to earth to destroy us. For Christ's sake, shoot!
Calm down, Nathaniel. Nobody here wants to hurt you. Put the gun down. Gently put the gun down on the floor.
Demon, you shall regret confronting the emissary of the Lord. You shall know divine power.
I shot him.
Yep. Looks like you did. Can't say I'll miss him. Come on, let's go.
Sir, baby screaming inside. Not a promising start. Anybody home? Mrs. Bowles. Oh, Jesus. Wait a minute. Hello, little cuties. Oh, you looking for your mama? Mrs. Bowles, are you there? Mrs. Bowles, can you hear me? Wake up! Wake up! I'm gonna call an ambulance.
No, I don't want to go to the hospital. Please.
Okay. You got something around here I can dress this wound with?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, don't move. I'll be right back. Let's see. I need this, and this, and this. I'm here for you, Susan. You'll be all right. I'll take care of you. Ah, I need more. Still bleeding. Not perfect, but it'll do. Stay with me, Susan. Susan, do you hear me? Susan, stay with me. Can you hear me? Stay with me. Okay, come on. There, I done what I can. That should stop the bleeding. Well, luckily, the wounds aren't too deep. Hey, how are you feeling? Okay?
My baby. My baby needs me.
Right. You stay there. I'll take care of the baby. Okay?
Do you know what to do? With a baby, I mean.
I'm a private eye. There's nothing I can't do.
Her name is Emily.
Gotcha.
Hey!
Hi there, Emily. So, what seems to be the problem, huh?
Oh! Going by the smell, I got a pretty good idea. Okay. How do you do this again? Fresh new baby. That should feel better. Right, Emily? Hey, what's the matter? I thought we solved the problem. I guess I better warm this thing up. Just tilt this bottle a little bit so you don't choke. Good job, Emily. You're feeling good now, right? Now, I'm going to rock you very gently so you can have a nice little snooze.
Thanks for looking after my baby. I didn't want to leave her. I just couldn't cope anymore. Just not having Jeremy around. He was such a good boy. Can't understand why anyone would want to hurt him.
Do you take care of this baby on your own? Doesn't Jeremy's father live with you anymore?
He disappeared.
the day after Jeremy. I don't know what happened to him. Maybe he couldn't take it. Ever since I've had to look after Emily all on my own, and I couldn't do it anymore.
I understand. Did your husband say anything before he disappeared? Did he leave a note or something?
No. He left the house without a word, and there was just a cell phone.
A cell phone?
Yeah, I found a cell phone in his dresser. I'm sure it wasn't his. I'd never seen it before. I tried to turn it on, but it didn't work.
Do you still have it?
Yeah, it's in a drawer in the living room. You can have it if you'd like. I'm sure it's of more use to you than to me.
Do you have any family or anybody to help you?
Yeah. My mother. I didn't want to ask her for anything. We don't really get along. But I guess I'm out of options.
Well, look after yourself. And Emma.
I will. I promise.
Excuse me? Hey!
Oh! Ah, sorry. Didn't see you. What can I do you for?
I'd like to get my car.
Hey, you're a pretty patient guy, you are. That car's been there for 2 years. We took it out for a drive every month and checked the tires and batteries, just like you said. Here, it's the third floor down. Service elevator is at the far end of the garage. Now, you have yourself a good one, Chief.
Your destination is 4 miles from here. Leave the parking lot and take the first right.
I can do it. I'd do anything to save my son. I don't want to die. Not here. Not like this. If I succeed, I'll get more letters from the hangman. It's my only lead. No turning back now. A lot of good it'll do Sean if I kill myself on this highway. I've got to do it, for Sean's sake. I have no choice.
Come on!
Atmosphere here is one of concern, as there is still no news of 10-year-old Sean Mars, who disappeared yesterday. A recent report indicates that the police are now treating this as another kidnapping by the Origami Killer. If this information is confirmed, he may still
be alive.
Hello
there, sweetheart. What can I do for you? 3 to 5 days
after I'd like a room.
For you? Anything. Feeling the register. Madison, page 27, single. How long will you be staying with us, Ms. Page?
I don't know yet.
Room 201. Last floor, stairs on the right, in the courtyard.
Thanks.
The pleasure was all mine.
That's for sure. You all right? I'll call an ambulance.
No ambulance.
You're badly hurt. You need a doctor.
Please, just help me to my room. It's number 207.
Got the key? you're really in bad shape. You should see a doctor.
Must have one, maybe two broken ribs. It's not fatal. But it's sore as hell.
Your head is bleeding. It looks deep. Paracetamol painkiller. Administer in cases of intense pain. Do not take more than one pill every 24 hours. Here. Take this. It should do you some good. It's a painkiller. It'll help reduce the pain. It says on the box to take one every 24 hours. I don't think it's a good idea to exceed the dose.
I can't afford to wait.
I should disinfect his cuts. I'm gonna disinfect your wound. This might hurt a little. Sorry. Are you okay? Sorry. I'll try to be more careful.
Listen, thanks for your help, but I think I can take it from here.
Right. I better go.
By the way, I'm Ethan.
Madison.
Was that the first time?
Sorry?
First time you killed somebody.
It always does something to you the first time. Then you get used to it.
If you hadn't acted like that for the guy, it wouldn't have happened. So back off! That's him.
You're Slav Korda?
Yeah.
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions. Shit, don't just stand there. He's gonna get away.
Stop that guy!
Hey, man, watch it!
Hey, what's the matter with you?
Damn place is freezing. My hands are numb.
Where the fuck is Blake?
Come on. Show your ugly bastard face.
No way.
This time it looks like we got our origami killer.
All the newspapers are talking about Sean Mars, the kid who disappeared.
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. Let me take your coat. Please, take a seat. Didn't really expect to see her again. Wonder what she wants.
I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important, but a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of a letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
And you think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? You remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
It was mailed in the Carnaby district. The day before Johnny disappeared. Nothing particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came around, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation?
There's nothing you can do to help.
Your time, Mr. Shelby.
Wait. You're really something special, Lauren. I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
We're partners. Stay in the car.
Partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go. What are we doing here?
We come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? The bigwig tycoon from Kramer Construction?
His son.
You think maybe he's still gonna kill her?
For now, I just have a few questions that need answers. Another time.
Are we gonna be here long? This place gives me the creeps.
I'm gonna go find Gordy Kramer. You stay here till I come back. Okay?
Okay. Just let me know if you need me.
Anyone. Beat it.
Mr. Franklin. He says I should go up.
You talk so crazy if I shove that wallet down your throat? Beat it! I ain't for sale.
If I want to see Gordy Kramer, I'm going to have to go about it some other way.
Hi, I'm looking for Gordy. You know where he is?
I saw him a while back, but you'll be lucky to see him. He rarely hangs out down here with his guests.
Oh, really? Why bother throwing a party then?
Why don't you go ask him? So, did you find Gordy?
He's upstairs. I got two goons blocking the way.
Do you want me to handle them?
Hey, what are you going to do? Knock him out with a pair of high heels?
Leave it to me! Just be ready to go as soon as they leave the stairs!
Wait, Lord!
Mr. Kramer?
Shh! This is the best part!
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Origami Killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions. I'd like to know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get in the back of your limousine. That was the last time anybody ever saw him. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
I don't know why, but your story just doesn't check out. You're giving me the crap. Now, tell me something I can't believe.
Very well. I'm the origami killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then I dump them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on their chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. You're the one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.
It might be a trap. I had better be careful.
Thank you.
Glass. Broken glass. Sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it, slowly, so I don't tear up my arms. The match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind. I guess I don't really have any choice.
God! God!
It's over for me.
Oh, my God. Ethan. Ethan, can you hear me? I'm gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds. Look really bad. I need to disinfect your wounds. You've got a hell of a fever. Doctor, but I'll do what I can. Sorry. I'll go easier. Sorry. I'll go easier. Sorry. I'll go easier. Thank you. Your wounds are disinfected. Wait. Sleeping pills in his state? Not a good idea. Sorry, I'm stupid. I'm using anti-burn ointments on your cuts. Geez, I'm not sure I'm helping him. I better stop. How do you feel?
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel Act? You don't even know me.
When I was a child, I was always the one who used to fix my brothers up when they'd been fighting with the other kids on the block. I suppose I like to play the guardian angel.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. It's the kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but, it's not easy. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be asking you questions. I mean, after all, we hardly know each other. You have no reason to trust me.
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Maybe I could help you.
No one can help me. You've already done a lot, Madison.
Right. I'm gonna go. Take care.
didn't do it. I swear I didn't do it. I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no? Then why did you run away when they came to question you?